Okay, let's take a look at this opener. Yeah, I'll keep. We've got some powerful cards here. Alright, what do we want to do? I guess we'll play a Mana Vault and just pass. I don't want to use that to play the Signet. I can just play a turn 2 Moldrifter. It's not insanely powerful, but it's, you know, it's a potential play. I mean, it'll draw us into the land so that we can untap the Mana Vault. Yeah, I mean, why not? Just taking a damage every turn. Whatever. Okay. Come on, land. Yeah, next turn if we draw a land, we can just be like, land, Signet, Time Vault, go. Some Naya beats. Ooh. Come on, land. Do it for me. That was not a land. Man. Wish we saved the Mana Vault for Consecrated Sphinx. I guess we weren't going to draw it for a while, though. So I have to do this only on my upkeep? Man, that's way worse than Grim Monolith. I mean, maybe it just kills a Time Vault. Yeah. That would be fine. I mean, we have a Duretti. Alright. Let's cast the Mox. Playing the Mox because I do plan on untapping the Mana Vault next turn. So we have our main colors. Now we just need to draw our splash ones, I suppose. Although our opponent just stuck on two lands, though, so... We have not too much reason to complain. Woolly Thoktar. Yeah. Yeah. I don't think it's a Woolly Thoktar. No is the only option. Ooh, draw red. I mean, we could play the Duretti right away this turn. I don't know how much that does for us. Well, it's actually not terrible. Like, we don't need the mana so much. Like, if we discard two and draw two, we'll probably find answers. Okay, well, let me attack first. And having a Planeswalker on the board early seems good. What is this? Oh, okay. Because, I mean, yeah, presumably we'll draw land, and then we can just still play Consecrated Sphinx next turn. Like, I'm planning on discarding Thoughtseize Balance. I guess I only need to discard one. Nah. I'll discard two. You know why I discard two? Because if you discard two, you get one step closer. You get one step closer to Ralzeric. That's why I discarded two. So same like this turn, Yeah, I'm not going to untap the mana vault. Oh, jeez. Should have kept balance. Mistakes were made. Yeah, we're still fine. Yeah. I mean, it's probably correct right now to just set up for what do you get? Avacyn's Pilgrim? Okay. It's probably correct to just set up for an upheaval. So, I will actually choose to. Oh, yeah, I'll choose to untap the vault. Actually, I mean, can he beat a Consecrated Sphinx? Or is that the greedy play? Yeah, that's a greedy play. Well, actually, let me think about this, because he's going to kill the ready next turn. Do I want the ready to be alive? Let's see. What's wrong with just playing Consecrated Sphinx? It's bad to like Swords to Plowshares if he has that in his hand. The real question is, how is he going to beat Upheaval? Unless he has, of course, Armageddon. And if he has Armageddon, it's better to play Consecrated Sphinx. You know what? I'm gonna play the Sphinx. Let's see here. Well, let's just discard these two and, try to get one step closer to. I just wanted to get one step closer to the Rouseric. I'm just obsessed about comboing off here. It's all I want to do. I hope he didn't. That wasn't him setting a stop on his upkeep. Yeah. Draw the cads. Continuing to get ever so close to the combo. So I guess this turn I can actually choose to untap the vault, and I just need to be mindful of leaving my red untapped. He played a land, so that means he's not gonna play Ravages of War, which is good. Banishing Light. Okay, Banishing Light on the Consecrated Sphinx. All right. Oh my god. This is gonna make my upheaval even better. You know what? I'm not gonna untap the Mana Vault. I'm just playing upheaval next turn. I have access to 6 mana, and then I can play land, Mox. Yeah. Okay. This is going to be a blowout of a turn. And this is why upheaval is very dumb. In case you were wondering. Oh, we can actually play a replay the Duretti next turn. Oh no, he just killed it, never mind. Ha ha ha. Nope. All right. Okay. He's not gonna like us for this. Yep. Upheaval. Mox Pearl. Land. I can go Mana Vault into Signet Time Vault. Sure. Just so I don't have to discard as many cards. Here comes an Avacyn's Pilgrim. Wait, no Avacyn's Pilgrim? Let's see here. I can untap this and give him another turn. So that we can take another turn. Nah. All I wanna draw is a Rouserick. Come on, come on, come on. So for those of you guys, I am actually in a Swiss queue instead of a normal queue. And the reason being is, first of all, you guys get to see more cube matches. But secondly, they're giving out Mirage packs for people who win the draft, and those are worth literally nothing. So it's actually better just to play the Swiss queues and get... And then you can go infinite on Phantom points by going 2-1 or above, which should not be too difficult if you are a serial cubist. Yeah, so, and this is exactly the reason why, like, upheaval is very, very dumb. And also why you should not be playing mid-range strategies like this. If you don't have counter spells, I mean, you're really leaving yourself vulnerable. All right. I wonder if I can kill him in time. I do have a Tamiyo. Let's go with Island. Mountain. Yeah, we can cast a big revelation here. The question is, what do we have left? Because we did lose our Consecrated Sphinx. Do we have a way to kill the Journey to Nowhere? Come on, Demonic Tutor? Yes! Maybe he'll just scoop. Yes. Doing it. All right. Tap target permanent, then untap another target permanent. Tap. Untap. Take an extra turn. Nope. Untap. Infinite turns! I'm just gonna do this nice and slow because, like, I don't care about my life total for the Sphinx's Revelation, so I wanna just make sure I hit all my land drops and play everything that I can. Tap. Untap. Okay. I was actually really concerned about whether or not we could actually win the game. So we had a Tamiyo and a Dungeon Geist. Well, we would have cast an Impulse, so we would have put some of these cards in the bottom. And we probably would have been able to hit him to death with Dungeon Geist. But yeah, winning is a serious issue with this deck. So he was playing Naya. So I guess I need to be more careful about my Consecrated Sphinx. I mean, we don't have a way to kill enchantments outside of Crimson Grip, but I don't want to delve into a another color. There's a Serendip Efreet, which I mean does a reasonable job of blocking his guys. Like he has Bloodbraid Elves and such, but let's see. He did have a Jitte, so I think Ancient Grudge could be a reasonable card to bring in. And I mean surely there's a card to take out. We'll take out Thoughtseize. And I'll cut the Urborg. And we'll add a mountain just because we probably want. So now we only have one black source, which is cutting it a little close, but we only have Demonic Tutor. Let's see. Yeah, I don't care about the 3 damage as much as like the small potential of flashing it back with Selesnya Signet. Yeah, just no win conditions. All right, cool. You get an emblem whenever an artifact is put into your graveyard from the battlefield. I mean, we have Indelian Click too. We just discarded it last time. All right, whatever. Let's battle.